directly from the president. It has been suggested that we should rename as many as 10 of our legendary military bases, such as Fort Bragg in North Carolina, Fort Hood in Texas, Fort Benning in Georgia, and the list goes on. These monumental and very powerful bases have become part of a great American heritage and a history of winning, victory, and freedom. The United States of America trained and deployed our heroes here and won 2 world wars. Therefore, my administration will not even consider the renaming of these magnificent and fabled military installations. Our history as the greatest nation in the world will not be tampered with. Respect our military.
Many of the people for whom these bases are named were leaders held in questionable regard, but who were elevated during the Lost Cause movement. He goes on to say, we do not live in a country to which Braxton Bragg, Henry L. Banning, or Robert E. Lee can serve as an inspiration. What does the White House say?
Fort Bragg is known for the heroes within it that trained there, that deployed from there, and it's an insult to say to the men and women who left there, the last thing they saw on American soil before going overseas, and in some cases losing their lives, to tell them that what they left was inherently a racist institution because of a name. That's unacceptable to the president, and rightfully so. And I would also note, where do you draw the line here? I'm told that no longer can you find on HBO Gone with the Wind, because somehow that is now offensive. Where do you draw the line? Is it, should George Washington and Thomas Jefferson and James Madison be erased from history? What about FDR and because of internment camps? You know, should he be erased from history? Or Lyndon Johnson, who has a history of documented racist statements? And finally, what about people that are alleged by the media to be segregationists? NBC tells us Joe Biden didn't just compromise with segregationists. He fought for their causes in schools, experts say. CNN tells us letters from Joe Biden reveal how he sought support of segregationists in the fight against busing. Washington Post tells us that Biden's tough talk on 1970s schools desegregation plans could get him new scrutiny. And there are several more that where that came from. So I'll leave you with the question, should we then rename the Biden Welcome Center? Thanks very much, guys.